Welcome to One Chemistry. Always do your best. Now, let us see about Wittig reaction. We will see some basics and stereoselectivity of the reaction. Stay tuned for complete information. What is inside this video? We will see what is Wittig reaction and we will see the preparation of elide, which is the unique molecule. Then we will see the complete mechanism. Then we have a question that when E alkene will be formed, when Z alkene will be formed. So we will see one by one. Let us see what is Wittig reaction first. Wittig reaction means the carbonyl compound reacts with elide. Elide means it's ionic species. It is also called Wittig reagent, where the phosphorus attached with the triphenyl and carbon system. We will see very detail in next slide. In Wittig reaction, the carbonyl compound reacts with elide, which is the Wittig reagent, to form alkene. The main driving force for this reaction is phosphine oxide. The phosphine oxide is very stable because the phosphorus oxygen bond is very much stable. Here, the important thing you should notice, the new carbon-carbon bond formation is happening as well as its stereochemistry. Let us see the Wittig reagent, that is elide. It is a very important thing, you should know what is elide. Elide basically means the phosphorus connected with double bond carbon. It can be also written as the ionic species, which is phosphorus plus and carbon minus. The stability here comes from the triphenyl system. That's why it's PH3P and carbon. The elides are stabilized by opposite charge to each other. It can be written both as double bond as well as plus and minus charge. So you should know what is elide. How the elide can be prepared? Elide normally prepared from phosphine, reacts with alkyl halide. You use the strong base to remove HX to form the elide. The strong base is used because you are removing the two atoms from the carbon. So the elides forms from phosphine and alkyl halide. Let us see the important thing, what is really happening inside. The mechanism here is 2 plus 2 cycloaddition, where the two molecules combine and form the product. Let us see what is really happening. Here, the carbonyl and phosphine compounds form 4-member transition state. It is cyclic, so it's driven by phosphorus and oxygen bond. So the molecules are come closer. The final product will be the phosphorus took away oxygen, and the carbon and carbon new bond formation is there. The intermediate is called phosphophosphetane or betaine. So you should know alkene is the final product. So the normal question will be alkene is E or Z. We will see in the next slides. So when E and Z will form? The Z alkene is formed when there is a kinetic product, which is a very normal one. Z means the both alkyl groups are in same side. E alkene will form when there is a thermodynamically stable product. Otherwise, you can say stabilized elide or any anion stabilizing groups form E alkene. So, the carbonyl group attached with electron withdrawing carbon stabilize the product. So, the electron withdrawing group or any anion stabilizing group attached with the carbon in elide means you get the E alkene. So, you should know that normally Z alkene will form. If there is any stabilizing species in the carbon of elide means you get the E alkene. So, electron withdrawing and resonant groups form the E alkene. Let us see why it is really happening. Normally, it's all about the transition state. Okay, you should observe the transition state. Here, you should also see the arrows. The first one is the thermodynamic product. Second one is the kinetic product. Or you can say first one is E isomer. Second one is Z isomer. The first step of the reaction is the negative charge attack the nucleophilic carbon of the carbonyl system. So if it is a stabilized E-line means you have so much time, so it get reversed, so you get the stable product. Suppose it is the unstabilized one, what is really happening? You get the quick product conversion, so you get the quickly forming z-isomer. Here you should see the position of R1 there. The position of R1 is dictated by the intermediate stability, right? If the intermediate stabilized by electron withdrawing group, mean you get the e-isomer. If it is not stabilized, mean you get the z-isomer. So you should know stabilized or not, then only you will understand the thermodynamically stable product or kinetically stable product. Let us see the best example here. Normally you can straight away write, connect the both double bonds there. The first example is the carbonyl group reacts with the halide, you get the normal alkene. Second one is the phenyl system, where the stabilized halide will come, meaning the electron withdrawing group attached with the halide carbon, so you get the E isomer. Similarly, the electron donating group, which is destabilized the halide, form Z isomer. Here you see methyl group, which is the electron destabilizing system, form Z isomer. The last one is very much important because you get the cyclic product. The exam questions are come from this one. Here it is the heptane system where carbonyl and bromine in the same one. So what really happen is halide form inside and the ring will be cyclic. So it is called cyclic Wittig reaction. Next and very important thing is this Wittig reaction can be applied to all type of carbonyl system or imine system. Here I shown ketone, ketene, isocyanate, nitroso and imine. So you should know product is same, the elimination is same, you will get the same thing. So you should know that not only in carbonyl system, the substituted carbonyl system also you get the same Wittig reaction. Let us summarize what is really happened in Wittig reaction. Wittig reaction, carbonyl compound reacts with halide, you get alkene. Alkene can be E or Z. So what is the really catch here? You should see the substituted groups in the halide. If it is electron withdrawing group, the anion stability of the halide is high, so it will be non-reactive. So you get the E where thermodynamically stable product will come. Similarly, if it is electron donating group is there, mean the anion stability is low, it will be very reactive, you get the kinetic one, which is EZ. So you should know electron withdrawing group mean E, electron donating group mean Z. So the stability of halide dictate the stereochemistry. That's all from me today. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below.